probably be a quieter election season, they say, with the Commission on Elections putting a tight cap on political advertisements. It may even be cheaper, with a poll body declaring it will be keeping a close watch on campaign spending. With these developments, how different will this midterm election be, and just how are political parties taking it? Our question: do you think the COMELEC can monitor the political ads, airtime, and campaign expenditures? With us, Deputy House Speaker Erin Tanyada, spokesperson of the Liberal Party. Thank you for joining us. Navotas Congressman Toby Tiangco, Secretary General of the United Nationalist Alliance.
Good evening.
Good evening. We also have Christian Ceneres of the Democratic Party, and he is running for senator.
That's right.
And of course, we have the Commission on Elections spokesperson, James Jimenez. Okay, we will begin with those political parties and a candidate. We will begin with you, Congressman Tanyada. The stricter rules, what did you think of it, and what struck you the moment this was released?
Well, of course, we in the Liberal Party will follow the rules of the COMELEC, that's one. We feel that even with the stricter rules, I think the intention really was try to level the playing field. So we are in favor of that. Of course, the question is, will the COMELEC be able to really to monitor? And here it will test the COMELEC with the new leadership if they'll be really that strict in implementing their own rules. With regard to cutting down the number of airtime and radio time for the national candidates, I think it's really not a problem for us. We're in favor of it. But again, it becomes, I think, a bit absurd when we talk about local candidates.
Why the absurdity?
Because, let's say, based on COMELEC rules, and again, this has to be amended by Congress, 3 pesos per voter in your constituency. If you have a 200,000 constituency, you're just allowed to spend 600,000 pesos. Mm-hmm. So if you go on TV, wiped out, you mm-hmm. can't anymore spend.
What are the rates in the locals area?
It depends. If in Manila, if you come out in ABS, or mm-hmm. you can just see.
When you say local, is this mayor or
mayor,
is this congressman?
Yes.
Is this vice governor?
Yes.
And everybody else?
Yes, and everybody mm-hmm. else. So basically, the distinction between national candidates, senatorial level, and the congressional expenses should be looked at and made more realistic than what it is right now.
Okay, Toby.
Of course, we welcome it. No, mahirap yata mag-raise ng funds for 120 minutes. Even for 120 minutes alone, it's so difficult to raise funds. That's about 100 million pesos. No. So 120 minutes
per candidate.
No, 120. I'm talking about 120 minutes, whether per candidate mm-hmm. or per party. So 120 minutes is equivalent to about 100 billion pesos. So if it's not for the total, if it's not in aggregate totals, advantageous talaga doon sa madaming pambayad, no? Doon sa madaming pera. But I think I welcome what the COMELEC did because it somewhat equals the playing field. 120
in
minutes.
In what way?
Because you can just put out 120 minutes. Hindi katulad dati, kung tatlong TV station, apat na TV station, pwede ka ng 120, 120, 120, 120. That's 480 minutes. But now, total of 120 only. But I think the most important new factor here is that if you come out in a group ad, even if you didn't pay for it, the number of minutes that you came out there will be deducted to your 120 minutes.
Your total participation or your cutaway shot?
No,
of
your,
3 seconds?
No, your 3 seconds or whatever in a 30-seconder mm-hmm. will be deducted from your 120 minutes.
Oh, wow.
I think this is a reaction to the abuse during the last election. Because we remember there were ads in the last elections na 2 candidates, one came out for 40 seconds, one came out for 10 seconds, and then it's charged to the one who came out for 10 seconds.
Yes.
So that was subject to abuse. So this mm-hmm. one is better. It really equals the playing field.
Mm-hmm. Okay, sir. What about you?
I agree with
you're
you.
You're running for Senate.
That's right.
And your party is?
The Democratic Party.
Democratic Party. And
I was a former congressman, and I agree with my, well, only si Erin lang yung colleague ko before. Mm-hmm. But I agree with what the two of them said, that this does level the playing field.
And in what way? In what way do you think you will have a chance if you were running for Congress now?
I'm running for Senator.
Yeah, I know. If one were running for Congress or one were running for Senator.
Well, the limits, the new interpretation, which goes back to the 2007 interpretation, it's different from Abalos' interpretation in 2010, is that per TV station, I mean, aggregate, a total of 120 minutes from every appearance in every TV station, not just per station. Mm-hmm. And as a candidate of a new and small political party, and we don't have that much money, that really opens up the contest.
Okay. James, what was the previous number of minutes allotted per candidate national?
Well, it was always 120 minutes.
120 minutes, yeah. per candidate, per station.
But it was per station.
Okay.
And that was the big difference. Like the congressman said earlier, if you have 120 minutes per station, then you might well end up with 480 or whatever.
Okay. Were the 120 minutes per station, per national candidate, actually utilized by these candidates?
No.
So what was the average spend of a national candidate on the 120 minutes per station?
Well, for most of them, they did exceed 120 minutes, but not in every station. But their aggregate did exceed 120 minutes.
Okay, and what was the average cost of a 1 minute?
An average
per national on television, per national on radio.
The average TV ad is about 700,000. Last I looked, for 30 seconds. So that's
impossible. 700,000.
Depends on what TV show.
Depends on what TV show.
From prime time or prime time.
You get to
700,000.
That was the estimate.
Are you sure?
That's the rate card. That's the rate card.
The rate card 700 per minute.
Per minute. Yes.
That's prime time. Prime time. If you choose 3 a.m., then maybe.
No. But the going rate, as far as I know, I don't know if it's a special rate because it's election. It cannot be 700.
No, that's the rate card.
The rate card. So, but what is the negotiated rate?
It depends. No, because there are depends on the media buyer.
Who declared the 700,000 per minute?
Was this
the network?
These were estimates from people who would give us quotations. Prior to the elections, we had a lot of people coming in from various networks, actually.
And did you see the actual certificate of performance and the actual receipts that were provided by the network to the candidates who claimed they paid 700,000?
I'm talking about the rate for now, for the 2013 elections. This is the rate that's available. But in 2010, I don't have the estimates for how much they spent right now, but the bulk of their expenses did go to TV ads.
TV ads, and TV you're ads. Telling me now as we speak that the ongoing rate now, should they start buying within the campaign period, is 700,000
that was the estimate
per
that
minute.
Estimate given
Tina.
To us.
Estimate given to you by?
I cannot say.
Tina, the rate card given to you, you can ask for discounts naman eh. And it depends on the influence of the media buyer. It depends on how many clients he has. Kasi di ba nag-volume ba yung media buyer eh. Mm-hmm. So that's where they get discounts. Mm-hmm. So you will not pay 700,000.
Yes. You so how much is the negotiated rate? How much does it come out to?
I think you can get... we have ads, so I cannot say how much discount we're getting.
I mean, here we are trying to explain to the public the COMELEC rules on reducing the total political advertisements and the total airtime, which is different from ads.
Okay, pagdating ng February 12, the stations must give 30% discount on the rate card.
30% discount
on... So it becomes 490.
So half a million.
Per minute?
Yes. If it's 700,000, it becomes 490.
Okay.
Because they have to give at least 30. They have to. I was asking 30. James earlier.
30%.
30% means at least, no?
Okay.
But
to
of course,
everyone.
Yeah,
to everyone.
Okay.
To everyone.
So, okay, going back to James. James, you're talking of reduction in the minutes for political advertisements.
Yes.
These are ads.
Yes.
Prepared by either it's a radio ad or it's a TV plug.
That's right. Yes.
And this is a print ad as well.
We have reductions for, we don't have reductions for print ads. For print ads, we're keeping them the same. Maximum of 1/4 of a page of a broadsheet, 3 times a week. So it's roughly the same.
Okay. And then you're talking also of online, over the internet.
Yes. Yes,
and this ads. Affects which kinds of products on the internet?
Advertisements. Any adverts that they come out with online will also be subject to reporting requirements.
Okay, is a YouTube
video
exposure
that will not count against airtime minutes because that will be considered as a post on the web, and YouTube is free. The only problem that we have there is if you have videos that are being churned out, and obviously those videos have costs incurred in connection with their
for creation. The production of yes. what you're putting on yes. YouTube.
For instance, you have a talent. For instance, you have a celebrity stumping for you. Then we might consider that the services of the celebrity could be considered a donation, which you might then have to report.
Okay, so whose burden is it to monitor? Is it the COMELEC? Is it the candidate reporting to the COMELEC? Is it the network telling you who has appeared?
Well, it goes three ways. The candidate has to report how many ads they're putting out and what times.
Before or after?
After. The networks have the responsibility to give us the certificates of performance, the broadcast logs, and the COMELEC has the responsibility to monitor as the events unfold.
Okay, what is your monitoring capacity?
We have
national.
We have people who will be focused on that, and we are looking into partnerships.
You will have, if there are how many radio TV stations, you will have one person monitoring 10 TV stations?
It will not be like that. It
how
wasn't
is it?
Like that in the past. We have crowdsourcing techniques right now, and we will be able to get inputs from other people, from other sources, especially from advocacy groups that have made this their particular advocacy.
We're so also how is the job going to be distributed among those who will start counting the minutes
well, they will,
and the exposure?
They will do their own monitoring, we will do our own monitoring, and we will be comparing notes afterwards.
So how will the monitoring be done? In a day, the shape of the day, there is 18 hours or 24 hours per station.
Yes.
And this is the regular free TV types.
Yes.
So you will have a staff on 24/7 who will be monitoring a slice, 7 hours per person, who will monitor appearances, guestings on TV shows, on radio programs.
We will probably not have a 24-hour staff, mm-hmm. But we will be comparing what we get from the networks as reports, because we do have that every 2 or 3 weeks, mm-hmm. and we will be comparing that with what we have. We will be monitoring, we will start monitoring at around 5 a.m. for radio stations.
Okay, when does this begin? When does this actual monitoring begin? Campaign period
February
for
12th.
National is February 12th.
Yes.
March
so
29th.
So, 12:01. Mm-hmm. Of March of February 12, you would have started
right.
looking whether somebody was already appearing mm-hmm. on a 12:30
right.
12:30 right. a.m. show. Yeah.
But we don't
that
have
that actually can be seen overseas.
Yes.
Yes.
So it's not dead time for anyone anymore.
Of course.
Because if the signal is beamed live overseas,
right.
does that constitute?
It's not really what you see. It's what they pay for.
Mm-hmm.
It's what they pay for. So
okay.
If we get eyes on the ad, then that's
yes.
excellent. But if we don't get eyes on the ad, but we do have a record that the ad came out, then that will be enough for our purposes.
Okay. Is the capacity of COMELEC and its partners
yes.
who are interested in doing a monitoring to be able to provide this kind of electoral reform of evening out the playing field, is that something that you are going to be relying upon?
Well,
their report should be coming out after the entire electoral process is done, when the winner or the loser has been proclaimed.
Yes.
Or is this going to be done on a weekly, on a monthly? How many days are we talking about, Pa?
90 days for senatorial candidates and 45 days.
Okay, these are the number of days lang that
yes.
you'll be monitoring. So what do you
yes.
think? Is this something that is practical and can be and will be able to call the attention of anyone who on the 30th day has exceeded or is about to use up?
Well, this will be a test for COMELEC right now,
mm-hmm.
because if we go back to COMELEC history, I think there hasn't been yet really a person who has been caught overspending on TV or radio. So now that you've reduced the number of minutes in both mediums, then we will see if all the candidates will be able to comply based on the report that COMELEC will be submitting. And maybe this will also be a venue for future legislation, because like I mentioned, the election expenditures here are still the same election expenditures 20, 30 years ago, and this has changed.
Mm-mm.
So especially with regard to congressional and local candidates, I think this has to be looked into.
And have you seen the congressional candidates, the local candidates, exceed or complain about the 3 pesos per voter?
No. Mm-hmm. No one has complained, but I'm sure that when they submit their election expense report, it's always below the maximum amount, which I think is really absurd at this point. I don't think people are really telling the truth on
how
much.
Okay, so we're talking about paid ads.
Yes.
Paid. You pay and you have a receipt. If this is network, radio, TV, there is a certificate of performance, and that's easily... You can easily track that.
Traceable.
Yes.
Okay,
you
traceable.
You can monitor it.
You can monitor it. When it gets to interviews, this is where I think the discussion is is focused now.
Right.
I understand that the COMELEC is asking that a talk show like Talkback will have to ask permission that I am guesting somebody who is running for re-election prior to my even confirming whether they will appear or not. I have to get a permission. Why is that?
Well, I would not characterize it as permission in the sense that if you did go ahead with it, there would be no consequences to it, not to you, except to the candidate, perhaps. The candidate could be told the minutes. Mm-hmm. The idea here is so that we know where they're appearing and whether or not their appearance constitutes advertising. The idea
How
here
do
is
you
that
distinguish whether their appearance constitutes advertising?
First of all, if you only have one or two candidates and not the others in the same class, then that would be terribly unfair, wouldn't it?
What but if they if can't were, come? What if they don't like me as a host?
If they don't like you, then they should say so.
Okay.
If they don't appear, it's enough that you gave them the opportunity to appear. If they said no, then that's fine. They have no problems. But the thing is, you have to give them the opportunity to appear. It's not as if we're preventing people from making news or from covering the news.
Okay.
It's simply that when you have them in your show, we have to make sure that everyone gets a chance. Because otherwise, there is a tendency and there is a danger that only the really popular ones will get invited.
But don't you have a COMELEC hour?
Yes, we do.
Do you use it in all of the, how many television stations and how many radio stations?
That doesn't make it, that's not the point. I mean, whether
but that,
or not
that is
we
a
have
point.
COMELEC,
you have sequestered time from a network.
Yes.
You have not bought it.
Yes.
You have sequestered the time.
Yes.
And I understand that the airtime there also has a value for the network.
Yes.
Do they use it as a...
But wait, does that mean that any show can then be used as a platform for any particular
candidate? No.
Exactly.
I'm going back. No,
so
because you're saying you want everybody
exactly
to have a chance.
Yes.
Okay.
When it comes to talk shows,
are not invited, but like a show of Talkback, then I'm telling you, isn't there COMELEC? How many hours of airtime do you have as COMELEC?
We can get 60 minutes every day.
Every day
from a network.
And if you compute that,
yes,
the total number of radio stations, of TV stations, how many hours do you have?
That's a lot of hours. But that's not the point. Again, if everyone had the 60 minutes, just say everyone had 60 minutes chopped up equally among them, but then again, one candidate had your show, then that one candidate is still up on the others.
But Tina, can I react to
you that? You may not guest anymore in another show.
You can, but you have to give them the opportunity simply. If they say no, then that's their problem.
Tina.
That's all we're saying. So all we're saying is, if you're going to guest a political candidate, then you have to let us know. And if anyone else doesn't want to come, that's their problem. That's not your problem.
Mm-hmm.
All right? And if they do come and we know that it's there and we'll sanction it, then that'll be fine. Even if we don't sanction it and you have a guest on, that's also fine. It's not going to be
so it is not held against someone who will insist and he agrees to appear.
No, it will.
It will.
It will.
It will.
That's the problem, Tina.
That's the problem.
That is where it's at. So, look at Toby.
When I was reading it at first, I thought it was the responsibility of the network to ask permission. But I was surprised from James that it becomes now the burden of the guests. Like, for example, Erin and I came here. How do we know what questions you will ask us, number one? How do we know how many minutes we will be caught on air? And it will be deducted from us. What if we are resource persons for something about elections, but not about our candidacy? Like me, I'm SecGen and I'm running. But if it's something about the party, why should it be taken against me? So that's difficult. So who will appear in your show?
Nobody. these are now the questions that are being asked, because I want to be very clear on what was the basis of now guesting must be cleared in a manner of speaking. Not by the network, but by the candidate. So tatawag si Toby James, lalabas ako sa Head Start.
The burden is on the network, because it is the network that has to to ask for consent from the COMELEC. If you're producing the show, then you have to tell us who your guests are going to be.
We have to tell you who the guests will be. Is that infringing on our creativity?
No.
And our desire to be able to come up with a show that is going to be balanced?
No.
Why not?
Because it will not prevent, even if you don't do it, it will not prevent you from airing the show.
Even if?
Even if you don't get the COMELEC's consent, even if you don't tell the COMELEC, then it will still not prevent your show from airing.
Okay, you will stop us. You will stop us if you say Toby has appeared already in within the day in an ANC profile, in an ANC program. You're going to stop. You'll call Toby, or you'll call the producer of Talkback.
We won't stop anyone.
No, but you will charge the minutes to me.
Yeah.
So why is it my fault that I came here? Why does it become my fault that I came here to answer Tina's question?
Again, it is no one's fault. We're not saying that it's anyone's fault. It's simply that we have to know who the guests will be, so that we can make sure that everyone was given the same opportunity.
Okay, if we don't get, let's say, we don't know Christian here. We never heard of him.
I guess
are you now going to are you now going to say us? Are you going to tell us, "Uy, si Christian hindi pa lumalabas yan"? Are you now going to be suggesting are the people who have not had any airtime and nobody invited them?
Well, I don't think that's going to happen, number one, because we're talking about a very specific situation, and you know who the candidates are.
Everyone I'm talking of candidates.
Exactly.
Who are already out there but have not been in the radar of any show. So are you now going to look at your list? Oy, si ganito hindi pa lumalabas. Is that going to be part of your persuasion that why don't you invite so-and-so to take part, because you want to even the playing field there?
Yeah, here's how it's going to work. If you tell us, let's say you're inviting a mayoralty candidate.
Yes.
Right. We know who the mayoralty candidates are. If you don't know who they are, then we're going to tell you that these are the mayoralty candidates.
Yeah.
If you're not inviting any one of them, then that's fine. If you don't want to invite them, that's fine. But the person who appears on your show, he might get told minutes. That's the thing.
No, that's it. But given the bench of how many candidates there are, based on the number of days and based on the number of talk shows of radio, television, baka hindi na talaga maabot sa dami lang eh. Hindi talaga sila magi-guest. So ano ang gagawin nyo para maging even yung playing field? Because you want to help this candidate na hindi siya iniimbita. No, paano nyo matutulungan yung mga ganung klaseng kandidato, sir?
I think that the idea here is that broadcast programs such as this, they can be used as platforms for campaigning. And as much as possible, the COMELEC only wants to make sure that everyone in the same class gets the same opportunity. Now, we will tell you that you're missing out on some candidates, but we will not tell you to guess them. If you don't want to guess them, that's fine.
Okay.
That's your choice.
So but you're just going to be running after or compiling the cumulative minutes of this candidate who appear and must have consumed.
Yes.
And you're going to give them a warning.
Yes.
Wow, very interesting days ahead of us. We'll pause for a break. You can join this discussion on our question of the day. Do you think the COMELEC can monitor the political ads, airtime, and campaign expenditures? Text us, send us your tweets at twitter.com/ANC Alerts, and be a fan of Talkback with Tina Palma on Facebook. Stay with us.
sobrang haba na ng mga sinasabi na nawawala na yung punto sa dapat isagawa ng ano na isang politiko para sa mga mamamayang Pilipino.
Okay naman, para patas sa lahat na equal yung playing field, parang hindi sa sobrang iba. Iba, kung ito lang kaya nila, yun yung pwedeng gawin.
I think karapatan po nila yun kung gusto nila magkaroon ng maraming advertisement. So, hindi po ako sumasang-ayon sa paglimita. Kasi, napatunayan naman po dati na hindi naman ibig sabihin na mas maraming yung advertisements ay mananalo kabilang isang politiko.
Welcome back to Talkback. We asked our friends on Twitter and Facebook, how can candidates and political parties maximize COMELEC's new airtime limit for the 2013 elections? Joseph Gomez says candidates must have eye or ear-catching ads and jingles that would easily stick to one's mind, or they can go for social networking sites. Mark Angeles says they should make sure they're direct to the point with issue-based campaign ads tied to their name. He adds name recall is important. Day Yu says use internet as a substitute, but it's also under some kind of criteria now. If they have good ads posted on YouTube, YouTube is not included pala, and if netizens believe in their platform, it would be definitely shared through Facebook or Twitter. Political campaign would be like sort of multi-level marketing, less cost in television airtime. Still with us, Deputy House Speaker Erin Tanyada, LP spokesperson, UNA Sec Gen and Navotas Congressman Toby Tianco. It's not yet the campaign period,
not
so
yet.
They're not, Attorney James isn't conducting for your total. Christian Cineres, Democratic Party senatorial bet, and COMELEC spokesperson James Jimenez. Christian, share with me your experience now running as a senator. You've been a congressman. Was this a party list?
That's right. Buhay party list.
Buhay party list. So that was a certain percentage of the total votes cast.
That's right.
So you didn't have to go for the entire.
That's right. But I did campaign
you did
nationwide.
National, diba? Yeah, national pala, no? Okay, so ano yung feeling mo? Ano yung nararamdaman mo with these kinds? Is a COMELEC really after your chance of making it and giving you a multi-level playing
among
field?
Us,
you feel it? Where will you feel it? How are you feeling it?
Well, like Attorney said earlier, it's not really a requirement, but if you're compelled to report how many times you're guessing a particular candidate, then even though it won't be compulsory, somehow we feel that we'll have a bigger chance of getting invited to shows like this and other.
But what now if hindi ka na sa radar and there's so many, how many other candidates are there in the party list na lang, di ba? Kasali sila sa configuration of who the candidates are. Eh?
Mm-hmm.
The
there
mayor,
are
the vice mayor, the councilors.
The truth is, ever since we filed our candidacy, we have noticed that there are certain candidates who appear on TV more frequently, almost every day.
Okay.
But there are many of us who are lesser known. And we are the ones who need exposure. If you look at other countries, people are more interested in the third-party candidates or those who are underdogs. Mm-hmm. But it's not the case here. But somehow this new provision of these new rules would somehow change that.
Okay. James, the COMELEC can come up with any kind of rule as it pleases without any kind of hearing with the candidates. Is this how you come out with rules like this?
We have the authority to make the implementing rules for national laws. Mm-hmm. In this case, it's Republic Act 9006.
Okay, and the basis of that is this Republic Act 9006,
yes, ma'am.
Where the essence of that law
basically
is
we're just expanding on we're just fleshing out what the law already says. So
So this is the first time on the IRR, or are you adding the IRR now?
No, we re-promulgate every election.
And the promulgation is a collective effort by everyone or just kayo
lang? COMELEC and Bank.
COMELEC and Bank.
Yes.
And do you as a COMELEC and Bank consult resource persons on how
they do.
How we produce television shows, how we book our guests, the difficulty in getting guests, and so on.
We
and
did
so
have
forth.
Meetings with industry, but
yes.
More on the ad side. on the political ads, the minutes and all of that. We consulted with people from various networks. We consulted with KBP as well.
Mm-hmm. And what was the general sentiment?
Well, the KBP wanted more time.
To restore
the per station implementation. The representatives from the networks were more neutral about it. The most indelible takeaway that I had from that meeting was that they would treat it like ordinary commercial ads. So for them, it was, you know, either way, we're still gonna get the ads. And so that was it. That was the result of that meeting, and this is the result.
Okay, in the provincial areas where radio stations offer block time, does this form part of your COMELEC?
Yes.
Stricter rules and regulations.
Yes.
What happens to people who are candidates who have existing shows,
they
who
stop.
Are block timers? They are supposed to stop.
Yes,
mm-hmm. as a policy
way.
Of the network.
No, as a requirement of law.
Mm-hmm. As a requirement of law, they must stop appearing in a radio program that they host, and they are candidates.
Yes.
Okay, and when that time stops. You and he either guests on his show. Is that a different thing altogether? He will be a regular guest, or he will be provided a segment within a block time show that he continues to pay. Kasama ba yun sa ruling nyo?
No.
Do you also stop him from paying a block time cost?
Yes. Yes. Everyone who's on media,
no, he
radio, pay,
he
or
owns
TV?
The airtime. Eh? May block time contract siya. Hindi mag-e-end.
It
will go beyond the campaign period, and he continues paying. This, and he doesn't appear. He takes his son to appear in his behalf. Does that become?
He can no longer appear.
Hindi siya.
On that ad.
He but cannot, he's buying. He's paying the airtime.
That would be an election expenditure.
Because he can use that.
No, he's no longer, he's still paying for it, pero hindi na siya lumalabas.
And hindi niya ginagamit.
Ang guest na niya, kumuha siya ng isang friendship niya, o ikaw na lang mag-host.
No, but the problem is in the previous resolution, whatever you pay for is charged again.
Yes.
It's your election expenses.
As a candidate.
Yeah, so hindi ka dun madadali sa minutes, dun sa election expenditure.
Expenses. Hindi nga siya lalabas eh.
Yeah, but you paid for it.
I paid for it because it's still I'm still under contract with ABS that I will be paying this station until I don't want to lose my airtime. So I continue to pay for my block time, and I get a substitute host who will not maybe
mention your
sneaky,
name, or,
mention your name, but totally different. I transform it into a telenovela or
well, the I think the solution there is to ask COMELEC for permission to
Is that tutuloy niya yung kanyang block time? Hindi na siya kandidato yung appear.
I'll be honest with you. I've never heard of anyone wanting to keep on paying for time that he's
they
not
do,
gonna use.
Because they don't want to lose it.
Yeah, that's possible.
Negosyo niyo yun.
That's possible. Our concern there is whether or not that time will still be used for campaign purposes. If it is still used for campaign purposes, then definitely that will be counted against his expenditure.
If he decides,
if it is not used at all,
then
that's something that we need to talk
so
about.
Okay, so this guy decides to make money,
and sell
it to other candidates that he will now be giving exposures to.
No, then it will be charged to the candidate.
To the candidate now. He's paying for the block time. He has nothing to do.
No.
Okay, clear. Okay. you are una, and you have so many candidates. And what has the strategy been to be able to address these stricter rules in terms of coming out together, coming out in tandem? Ano ngayon ang adjustments na ginawa nyo sa una? Because merong ang panibagong stricter rules sila.
Okay nga sa amin yung adjustments eh. Because in the beginning, nung hindi pa kami sigurado, naman problema kami how to raise funds.
Okay.
For the 120 minutes.
Okay.
So imagine if it's, let's say, two stations pa lang, two or three stations. 120 minutes is about 360 million na.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, published rate. No? So, less 70 per, less 30%.
Mm-hmm.
So, malaking pera pa rin. So, yung adjustment dito is we're not as pressured anymore to raise that much funds.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi mas konti na yung airtime.
Okay, so that's paid ads, That's political propaganda, in a manner of speaking, appearing in shows or appearing in entertainment, appearing in game shows. Mm. Yung mga ganyan, di ba, ibibilang sa inyo. And then we already discussed about the internet, online election propaganda on the internet. So you're only talking about adverts. You're not. The YouTube is not covered.
No. Twitter, your posts will not be monitored.
Posts will not be monitored. Your production of the. Of the thing that's appearing on YouTube, material. What if it's done by your son and wants to take a picture of you eating with the family? I mean,
those will have to be evaluated. Again, laws, the resolution states if it is capable of pecuniary estimation. Yeah. The idea is very basic. If it costs a significant amount of money, then we will look into it.
What is significant? But, 50,000 above? To produce,
we'll have to see that. We'll have to see based on the material. Uh-oh. But if you're like taking it from your iPhone or
whatever, taking my iPhone, yeah. I went to spend my dad today, and then it's Toby eating, and then posting
it
there. I love my dad.
Yeah.
No, but I mean, they can go around.
The safest way is to ask permission from them, because there's a provision here that if it's something that's not stated here, the best way is to file.
Yeah, I don't know. Permission seems to be a very toxic word nowadays.
Okay.
No, but certainly advise the COMELEC. Tell us what you're intending to spend on. It's not like we're trying to clamp down on people spending money. I mean, you know, it's more on wanting to know exactly how much is being spent to make sure that the playing field is level.
But this is going to make a lot of other people more creative.
Yes.
Okay, let's go to the poster.
All right.
To the poster in the street. What is the rule now there?
Bawal.
Bawal. Walang common poster area?
No, there will be common poster areas, and I think that's one of the things that makes this resolution very different, is because it really articulates what public spaces are supposed to be.
Mm-hmm.
In the past, all we said was all you can post at are common poster areas. Yes. Don't post anywhere else. But now we're being more specific. For instance, vehicles of local governments cannot be used for posters. LED billboards are not allowed, that sort of thing. The basic rule remains the same. You can only post your printed materials on common poster areas.
Regardless of size?
No, there's size requirement.
Size is limited also.
Now control it like how you are trying to tell the networks that we must clear with you that from the printer, the tarpaulin printer, the printer, you already tell them that this is the only size and you will have to tell us.
Yes.
Where the installation of these posters are? No.
That's an enforcement
part?
Question. First of all, they will have to post only in common poster areas. That simplifies it vastly.
Yeah.
Because everything else outside that is a violation.
No, okay. Except private.
No. But you're talking
except
of
private houses.
Private homes.
Pero the number of copies that you will print.
Yes, but you can't.
Can you regulate the source of the printed materials, tarpaulin or brochures or whatever?
They won't, Tina, but lalampas ka doon sa
election expenses.
Doon ka lalagpas sa election expenses.
Kasi hindi nga, pinapadeclare ko na sa kanila na i-declare na kung magkano ang ginastos from the printing press point of view.
No, you will have to.
Before they even do it.
No, because doon sa poster mismo, nakasulat doon,
paid for
the candidate. Opo. So even if the candidate doesn't pay for it, it's charged to your election expense.
Yes. But
and
I'm saying,
by whom?
Can you do it? But before they actually print it.
Can you do what?
Can the COMELEC now go to the printing press or the tarpaulin maker and ask them also to submit to them? Si Toby nagpapagawa ng isang million.
No, they have to after.
Before.
After.
No,
we
won't do it before.
You won't do it before. It is after.
Yes. After.
And has it produce any value to you, the submission of all of these people who produce all of these?
Well, that's a perennial problem for us because when we see posters outside the common poster area and we call the person to task, first defense is that I didn't put that up.
Yeah, it's not me.
Not mine.
Hmm.
So that's one of the perennial problems that we have. But that is the law as it is written, and then we keep on trying to enforce it. Hopefully now, with more people paying attention to this sort of thing, especially with the run-up to the elections, people being very sensitive about that, we'll have a better success this time around. But the principles remain the same. Printers, Poster sizes are limited, 2 feet by 3 feet. They can only be put in common poster areas or, as reminded,
private
homes, as long as you have the consent of the homeowner
and
or the property owner. And
regardless of size, I can cover my whole
two by
front,
2 by 3.
Even
two
in
three.
The houses?
Yes.
Ah, okay.
Yes. And of course, headquarters, you have a little bit of leeway for that, and as well as rallies. For rallies, you can have bigger posters, I think a maximum of 8 feet wide. But you can put them only up. You can put them up only 5 days before the rally,
and
they have to be removed
day.
Within 24 hours.
Okay, final stretch. But the question is, you have your ano yung final ano yung final
meeting the advance.
Meeting the advance.
Yes.
Kakasali ba yun sa bilangan? The final stretch of talk back in a moment. Stay with us, please.
Okay na limitahan ng COMELEC yung gawin na lang 120 minutes. Kasi naman, yung mga tao na may pera, dire-diretso sila sa pagko-commercial, masyado silang nagbibigay ng mga exposure sa kanila. So lugi naman yung ibang kandidato na walang gaan ng resources para mag-ano ng mga advertisement.
Kung titignan po natin yung political culture ng Pilipinas, hindi po siya okay. Kasi kailangan talaga ng mga tao na makita yung bawat politiko. So, parang parte ng pangampanya talaga. It's part of the game.
Tama yung ginagawa ng COMELEC na nililimitahan lang ng 120 minutes ng ads for politicians. Parang unfair naman din kasi dun sa mga ibang politicians na walang financial capabilities na ganun eh.
Welcome back. Our question, do you think the COMELEC can monitor the political ads, the airtime, and campaign expenditures? That's what we were trying to ask today. Do you think they can do it and give us a reasonable amount of feedback after these new guidelines have been imposed?
Well,
did you come up with a report last time, 2010?
Yes, we did. Yes, we did.
And what was the compliance? Nobody overspent?
that came, the reporting on the money came later. But I think some of them might have overspent, but we needed to back check it, and that's
you haven't
really,
done
really difficult
you haven't
work.
You haven't done you haven't completed
well,
the back checking
officially
yet.
Everyone came in below the limit officially.
Okay,
well, so again, this will be a test with the new administration. They're trying to be more proactive now. If they are able to succeed, then this will be a challenge for the incoming Congress to come out with political party reform.
Listening to James now coming to explain how they will be implementing it, are you satisfied that there will be a reasonable amount of data that we will be able to gather to be able to do new legislation, if at all?
I think we'll be able to gather enough data, mm-hmm. especially in Congress right now. There's always the perennial bill that has been filed, political campaign reform. So whatever will be called from this election experience, I'm sure will help the incoming 16th Congress to flesh this out, especially with regard to expenditures in the local level.
Will we be having more people coming to run for Senate and Congress given this kind of ruling by the COMELEC, that I will have a better chance if I'm not popular?
Well,
I think incumbent.
I think there's a different gauge on whether to find out if a candidate is a nuisance candidate. They
okay.
don't look at the capability on whether he has enough resources,
mm-hmm.
because resources can come later on.
Okay,
if he's able.
That's
to.
That's a good point. Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
So I think this will.
Will it encourage?
It will encourage. It will. Yeah. It will encourage, knowing that COMELEC is being proactive in trying to level the playing field. So I think it's a step forward. But again, we should also look at later on political campaign reform, which ultimately will help even unknown parties who have registered to come out and to join the electoral contest.
Unknown parties just coalescing with known parties makes them like a known party. How about you, Christian? What do you think?
I think it's practical. Earlier you asked
practical,
about
practical, yes.
Because you know, since I filed my candidacy, there have been several groups who've approached me and told me that since you started, you've appeared in so-and-so radio stations and TV programs certain so-and-so number of times. So private groups are doing it, so there's no reason why the Comelec wouldn't be able to do it. And they have been monitoring every single candidate, all 33 of us, and they're even offering to give us the records of our rivals, other candidates.
This is during the pendency of your campaign period?
Yes,
the 90
before
days
the campaign
or
period.
After?
Before, ever since October 5.
On a daily basis,
yeah, the deadline,
meron kayong reporting.
The deadline. So there is data out there that has that recorded.
Who stores this data on the daily and on
a
daily
groups.
Kind
I don't know
of
if I can name them,
performance?
He's talking about private groups being able to provide
data, selling
like
this
tracking
information.
Data. And yes,
and then
that
they
data is for sale. Yes, that data is for sale.
They make money also.
They make money. Huh?
Oh, everyone has to.
Okay, Toby, where do you think this must be improved? If at all, there is an area there that needs improvement. Because you, on a whole, you think it's good.
Yeah. I think it's good.
It's not going to make you raise more money than. Like what is just demanded of this number of minutes per candidate, so major, the
good.
Pressure is not so heavy.
The idea of equaling the playing field is good. Whether or not they will be able to implement it, I assume that they will, because I don't think they will come out with a resolution that they cannot implement. Mm-hmm. And of course, as Secretary General of the UNA, we have to make sure that we follow the resolution and not run the risk of our candidates being disqualified.
But will you be, now that it's a 90-day period, is it too much to ask the Comelec to be able to give a 30-day report on how it has been utilized and how you're monitoring it, to give everybody an idea of where everybody is at in terms of political advertisements, right. In terms of airtime exposure, in terms of online advertisements? In other words, will you be giving
periodic reports,
at least?
Yes, we intend to.
I think that should be something that all of us should look forward to, so we know exactly how they are going to be implementing these rules that are just so many.
Yes.
And maybe you are going to be adding on, partnering with groups, or are you going to do it inside the Comelec?
No, we're
who is the lead group in Comelec who will be able to answer all questions apart from you as a spokesperson?
We have a group, it's called the Public Information Group, that's under our project management, which has overall management over the elections.
How many people is that?
That's about 32 people.
32 people, yes. and the task is?
10 of those will be dedicated to monitoring social media.
Okay.
And then the rest will be doing other work, like monitoring, of course, mass media. We're also looking forward to crowdsourcing a lot of this data. We're going to partner with a lot of agencies. Mm-hmm. And we're also exploring the possibility of getting a little professional help.
Yes.
So these are the possibilities that are open to us right now.
Professional help in maybe tracking the guesting. They
monitoring.
Can do that because these
media
are
monitoring.
Media monitoring, because there are people who just do the ratings for us, and they watch every minute and every second of where it's moving. What about the common poster area? If you see people violating, candidates violating, and they're not in common poster and they're in other public places,
we're setting up
Who is the one who will tear it down? MMDA?
The election officer. We have election officers in every city and municipality. That's more than 1,600.
Okay.
And they will have, each of them, task forces. Within their jurisdictions, they will partner with DPWH or DILG at the local level. Here in Metro Manila, we'll probably partner with MMDA.
Yes.
And there will be periodic sweeps, so that we'll take down all of these things. But again, I'd like to emphasize, taking down these things are the responsibility of the candidates.
Mm-hmm.
And in fact, they are supposed to take down all of these things, posters, streamers, whatnot, before the start of the campaign period. We will be sending them reminders as the election period draws, as the campaign period draws near. But again, on a daily basis during the campaign, people can report to us. We have the authority, motu proprio, we always say, on our own, to take these things down and to initiate
and
the
you will do it
cases.
And you will not call the candidate Toby, we saw your poster, stare it down until 5 o'clock today. Wala kayong ganun.
Meron kaming ganun.
Meron silang ganun. And you have to take it out. Otherwise, it will be assumed that you posted
that it's
it.
It's yours. And
so, it you violate. So what is the violation if Toby posts?
Huwag naman ako yung example. No? Sumusunod naman ako.
It's an election offense.
Bakit naman? Election offense. And what is the...
Which means
what
that...
Is the, what is the penalty for
yes.
this offense?
It's,
if you win, you will not win.
Well, you will probably be disqualified.
Oh, kaya nga wag na akong example.
I learned a lot today, and I look forward to a report. The first report on how this thing is being monitored and even really seriously looked at as a serious kind of a reform now on political ads, on airtime appearances, on social network. And campaign posters. That's all the time we have. Thank you very much,
Thank you.
Erin,
Thank you.
Toby, Christian, and James. Maraming salamat po. Talk to us again next week on Talkback.